Hi, crafty friend, it's Mona here. Thank you so much for joining me. If you need lots of cards at once, then this bulk card making tutorial is for you. For these cards, I have used these beautiful spring floral stencils, the spring eggs stamp and die set, as well as the Happy Easter word die. I prepared heavyweight cardstocks in different colors and shades for the ombre monochromatic look. I am cutting a bit larger piece from each color than the stencil. Because this is a quick cards kind of project, I suggest you to choose those cardstock colors which you are using the most. For me, they were the pink, yellow, and teal colors, so I already knew which lighter and darker shades coordinates perfectly with them. Now the cardstocks are ready for dry embossing. The process is the following. First, I put a metal shim to my platform because I like when the emboss texture is deeper. Then I am putting on it my 10 embossing mat. Next, I am placing my pre-cut cardstock to the mat, then the stencil which I want to use. You can also fix it with low-tech tape, but it is not necessary. To the top, I am placing the embossing plate and running it through the die-cut machine. This way, the stencil works like an embossing folder, and with the pressure, you get this beautiful embossed pattern. Next, I will give an elegant touch to the dry embossed base with the Gold Glitz Glitter Gel by Thermoweb. First, I am spraying pixie spray on the stencil. This will keep the stencil on its right place, and I can reuse the stencil many times. Just check my trick how I am using it over and over again. I am just applying the gel with spatulas through the floral stencil set. You really don't need to add too much gel to it because this stencil is not too intricate. I am applying the gel this way, and once I cover the entire area, I am gently removing the stencil, and this is how it looks like. Because this is a bulk card making project, I am repeating the same process for all dry embossed pieces. The process is always the same, but because I can touch the glittery stencil, I am using two stencil pads. With the first one, I am fixing the stencil to the cardstock this way. And with the second one, I am applying the glitter gel and also removing the excess to reuse it again. Maybe this looks too much work and time at this point, but I am making more cards at once. And for this, the time for making one card is in truth less. If you like this inspiration but you don't need more cards, feel free to do it for one card only. This is just an option to make more at once. When the last cardstock is done, I am letting them air dry for 1 hour. I am washing the stencil and the tools with soapy water immediately, and the stencil looks like a new again. While the glitter gel background dries, let's make some die cutting. Because my background will be bright and colorful, I will create a sentiment from white cardstock. I made a couple die cuts with the same Happy Easter sentiment die set from a white heavyweight cardstock and added 3 pieces together to have a heavy chipboard looking sentiment. Because this is going to be an Easter card, for me, eggs are mandatory part. I am going to use this beautiful spring eggs stamp set with its coordinating dies. I am going to stamp these eggs with Versamark watermark ink to a piece of vellum with the help of my Misty. Next, I am heat embossing it with gold fine embossing powder and a heat gun. I am in love with them and they look so amazing without coloring too. I die cut them off camera to save you a little time, and now I have everything prepared to the bulk card making. So it's time to put together the background. I am going to create an ombre look by cutting the prepared dry embossed and glittery floral cardstock. Basically, I am going to make a monochrome color block background and cutting all the cardstocks where the pattern ends. Then I am pairing them in ombre direction from the lightest to the darkest and trying to follow the original pattern this way. When the mix and matching is done, I am adhering the cardstock stripes to their right place. But here you have more opportunities again. You can use a single color background if you prefer that one. Just cut it to the right size and adhere to the card base. Or you can create a gradient background with mixing and matching triad colors as well. Next, I put the Happy Easter sentiment die cut to the card base with liquid adhesive and continuing with the vellum pieces of X as well. For those, I am using sticky square adhesives because I can roll it, and with that I can give depth to the translucent X. Next, I am adding dots with liquid adhesive to the center of the flowers and applying gems on them. As always, the used supplies are linked to the stores in the video description below. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please give me a thumbs up, it always helps. And if you want to see more content from me, hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for your time. Bye!